a fright. Why the devil don't you go and ask the groom or the maids instead of bursting in without a warning like a fool?
I beg your pardon, dear father.
There's no harm at your age in being so full of life, just as at mine I surely hope to find calm and resignation. Your dear uncle came today to see me, deprived me of my midday nap, so I was trying now to rest a little while, and maybe dozing. Why do you want to see your sister?
Rosita Damas, at very left, soon enough he saw that he must turn back, or he would have been in strife, stopped by a mob of infuriated peasants. I have heard that they will burn the effigy of Remy on the front of his palace.
Indeed, let them burn it. When wine is plentiful and cheap, you may well expect that spring will heat the blood and cause a deal of trouble. Never fear, it will pass.
If you'll kindly allow me to speak my mind and say exactly what I feel, I would suggest that concerning the conveyance of my sister Blanche, that your prophecy is definitely quite wrong. The mask has seen him, he stays by the crown, below the Rodney busy.
And the crowd, the carriage, forgive me. Visions like those torment my sleep, haunt me night after night. I hear a lot of talk of rebellion, sometimes even revolution. Those who never watch the crowd in panic will never understand. Those frightened faces with their features contorted, thousands and thousands of eyes. That night, it was the wedding of the young dauphin. Everyone is watching the fireworks. A case of rockets catches fire, exploding. Panic over against the crowd, driving them from fancy. Your mother quickly knocks the door of the carriage, and the groom whips the horses on faster, faster. Now the crowd turns the carriage, while the castle window is smashed. Just in time, the carriage is freed by the arrival of soldiers. It was later that night, in the stillness of this house, that your dear mother died. After giving birth to Blanche.
Monsieur, can you forgive me? For I should have known better. Once again, I fear I've behaved like an utter fool.
I should know better at my age than to get so excited. But my carriage is sturdy, my grown horses are never afraid. Antoine has been with us 20 years. I can assure you, your sister will come to no harm.
No, it is not at all for her safety, I fear. But as you know, Blanche is so highly strong, even morbid.
Blanche is really just an oversensitive child. A happy marriage soon will take care of that. You'll see, any pretty girl has the right to be just a wee bit nervous. Be patient.
You will yet have nephews as wild as 20,000 devils.
Mark my word, more than fear endangers my sister's health, perhaps even her life. It is not fear alone that makes her suffer. Something
but you sound just like a superstitious fool. Blush, I am sure, is a normal young girl. Sometimes she's even quite playful.
Yes, you're right. There are times, I must admit, when I too am deceived. I'd be inclined to think she was well if I did not see the signs of illness.
Soon enough, when Blanche and her companions come running through this very door, you will laugh at your beginnings, and she'll forget her own.
When it involves my sister, the very thought of fear fills me with foreboding. My young girl, who is noble and proud, yet fear is destroying her, even as the worm destroys the fruit.
What childish nonsense! Blanche! Your poor brother was so very impatient for your return.
The Chevalier, my brother, is too kind to his baby lamb.
You should not repeat so often nursery talk that makes sense only to ourselves.
Oh, no, little lambs are not supposed to stray far away from the fold. It is true that in my own carriage I should feel safe.
You there at the crossroad near BC told me with pride how you sat by your window looking perfectly calm and courageous.
Ah, Monsieur de Damas, without any doubt, saw only what he wished. Then you believe that I was calm and courageous. Good Lord, that jumps into danger. The breath from your body, then it becomes most refreshing. After you've gone in up to your neck, at the convent this morning, the service was extremely long. I'm afraid it left me completely exhausted. That is the reason, no doubt, for all of my moans. And now, if you'll excuse me, Father, I will go upstairs to my room and rest before supper. Ah, isn't it darker than usually tonight?
I'm afraid there's a storm coming nearer and nearer.
You used to say,
Imagination always flies from one extreme to another. What did she mean? I'd like to know. My dear, it was nothing at all, nothing serious.
Oh, monsieur, you've been indulgent all my life, such a kind and loving father.
Let us not speak of it anymore. If you were not so proud, you would not be so disturbed by a cry. One should not renounce the world because of spite.
I bear the world no special hatred. For me, the world is very strange, like an alien place in which I cannot live. Yes, dear father, I am quite unable to bear the noise, the breathless pace, the fearful strain. If my nerves were only spared the attempt, then you would see how much I could accomplish.
My beloved child, if this is so, only your conscience can decide. whether this attempt is more than your strength can endure.
Dearest father, let's end this game, I implore.
Footstool of indulgence, alas, the
Severities of our order cause you no fear. They attract her. Oh, yes, your heart is generous and noble. What has drawn you to us?
In Go in peace.
Envied you. Envied me? I can't believe it. This is absolutely the strangest thing I have ever heard. Envied me? I am it is little that I deserve to be punished. Oh, I've been spoken so modestly of my death. Oh, no, we love it, love it, love it. Oh.
quite frankly. Just how much time, Monsieur Jarlin, who believes that I can steal and hold it? He says your constitution is remarkably strong. I think he fears you will have a long and bitter struggle. But God himself become a shadow. Alas, I've lived as a lamb for 30 years. I've been burned as a superior for 12.
Here, Oscar took If I'm speaking rather harshly, now, My faithful daughters, I think that some among you already have heard what I'm now about to say. There are those who'd keep me from performing my duties, and the mass I've just completed here will be my last. Of God is empty. I partake today of the grief of our early Christian fathers. Today's a very great day for Candel.
This very moment, an outcast.
But if what I hear is true, I'll be killed. If they will find you,
they will not recognize me, so do not fear.
You're going in disguise.
Yes. These are the orders that we have just received. This is the blood. mutual in danger. I will have to leave when the crowd assembles to watch the procession. They'll be gathered in front of the city hall. The streets will be deserted. What will happen to you, my daughters, if they should find me here?
Occupied by active members of religious societies and orders, have to be vacated at once by the aforementioned parties, and must be offered for sale with the full approval of the proper authorities.
Is there anything in this decree to which you object?
How can we possibly object when you have left us nothing at all?
Somehow to get rid of the patrol. You will be alone until the workmen come later on tonight. But beware the blacksmith named Blancor. For sure he's an informer.
Thank you. mind. let the youngest be first. Sister Blanche and Sister Constance, if you please.
Citizens, I congratulate you all on your excellent behavior and on your public spirit. But I have to warn you now that we shall henceforth be careful to observe you all. No more living in communities, no more dealings with those who oppose the law, foes of our republic, nor as priests who plot against the state, henchmen of the Pope and of tyrants. You will appear before the court today, one by one, and receive the cards that will allow you to enjoy once again all the blessings of freedom.
Last night when we met, he agreed he would say Holy Mass for us this morning. But now it's very clear that this would be far too dangerous for him and also for us. Do you not agree, Mother Marie? I must rely upon your reverence for everything I should or shouldn't think about. If I was wrong to act the way I did, it is true the same. Once something is done, it is done.
Oh, Thank you. Madeleine Lidwon, Anne Pellerat, Madeleine Touré, Marianne Anissé, Marianne Pécor, Marianne Bridon, Marie Cyprienne, Brore, Rose Chrétien, Marie Dufour, Angélique Rosel, Marie Gabrielle Fresel, Marie Geneviève Meunier, Catherine Soiron, Thérèse Soiron, Elisabeth Bézelon, gathered in defiance of the law, in secret meetings, aimed against the revolution, also engaged in correspondence with our enemies, spreading rumors most dangerous to freedom, whereas they constitute a body of rebels, openly seditious, who maintain within their hearts the most criminal desires, and hope to see the people of France enslaved once more by tyrants, see their freedom flow in the torrents of blood, which all their treachery and evil design have brought about in the name of love.
doing? Of what importance is your wish at such a moment? Courage! Was only gentle, he may please.
I'll talk of matters of war.
It was God who accepted your vow. It is to him alone that you would answer, and not to your companion.